Hello everybody, it's Mel with Body Care Boutique, and I am going to make some soap. It's going to be fun. It's kind of Valentine's Day related, but just felt like making it. I got some really cute new embed molds and wanted to play. So, I'm going to play. Let's see if I can get this. I'll do it over here. Okay. I'm going to strain my lye here. So I had a lot of fun yesterday with the soap I made, the Seahawk soap that Holly with Missouri River Soap, and she challenged me to make a soap because she's into the Denver Broncos and I'm into the Seahawks. So we've been bantering all season with my husband, because him and I are Seahawks fans, so... We've been going back and forth with her all season, talking smack, and so it was fun. She challenged us, or challenged me to make a Seahawk soap. She made a Bronco soap, so that was a lot of fun. Okay, I'm going to go ahead and add in my sodium lactate. And I still had, please don't fall. Still have my milk in the microwave. I had to heat it up a little bit. I normally add that after I stick blend, but that's okay. Not too worried about it. This is just a low for me to use and give to friends and stuff, so. And I don't want to blend too much because time to play with it. And I did add in a little bit of colloidal oatmeal into the oils. Okay. So what I'm going to do is three different colors. I'm going to do white, pink, and red. And I'm using tomato red from TKB Trading. This is a good size bottle. I really like the size of the bottle because, you know, I hate going through colorants really fast. It just, I don't know why, it's kind of my peeve. It just annoys me. So it's nice to have a big bottle. Not really have to worry about it. Okay, so... Let's get these poured out here. I'm soaping mostly at room temperature. I mean, it's, you know, it's a little warmer. The lye was, my water was a little warmer. But I'm only going to do a little bit of white just for the piping on the top. So I don't want equal amounts of that in the colored. Just do a little bit less of that. Sorry, I gotta get in the way here. It's not like scraping a container is that exciting. And the fragrance I'm using is You Sexy Thing You. It smells really good. I got it from Nature's Garden. The first one I'm going to mix up is, if I can get the lid off, titanium dioxide. I want this pretty white. Oh, wasn't that lovely? My bottle just peed all over the place. Mmm, nice. Not real thrilled with that bottle, let me tell you. I think I'm going to have to switch them out. Can you even see what I'm doing? Probably not. Okay. So I'm just mixing the white. That's not enough. So let's do a little more, shall we? That is a messy bottle. I have some more. I think I'll have to use a different one next time. I'm getting quite the white I want, so that's just way too cream colored. Which isn't a bad thing, but I really want white. Look at it, it's coming out the side of the lid. Sheesh. Crazy. Okay. Hopefully that did it. I used the water dispersible titanium dioxide. Jeez, I would hope that'd be enough. I'm gonna have stick blend too here in a bit, so that should get it nice and good. You know, I'd really love to play music in the background. I love to listen to music when I'm making soap. Kind of like my thing, but I don't know. They always wow about copyrights, but it's not like we're selling the music. But whatever. Okay. Now this one, I want to make just pink. I don't want it to be red, so I don't want to add too much, which I may have just done. You know, I think I'm going to add a little titanium in here because that's pretty yellowy to start out with. Get some of that in there and then it'll make it look a little more like I want. I love to have liquid colorants. I don't know. I know some people really like to mix colorants, and it's fun. I like to do that too, but I just like being able to squirt it in there. I mean, I don't master batch really most of the time, so it's like, you know, my oils and stuff. So I have to get everything ready each time I soap, and, you know, it can be time consuming. So I like to be able to just be able to dump it in. Boy, you know, I should have put titanium dioxide in the whole batch, huh? That's what I should have done to start with. So pardon me while I take so much time to do this. You guys can fast forward through this part. You've seen it probably a billion times. You know what it looks like to get colorants mixed up, so and I need to grab another spatula.
Yeah, I think it helps just to, when you're doing these colors, to just get it kind of lightened up beforehand and then work with your color. Because when you're starting out like a beige or a yellow, it does interfere with what you're trying to do with the color, so. We'll just mess with it till we get it right here. So, my husband left for work, and I went back to bed, and I was laying there, going, okay, go to sleep. All I could think about was soap, so I just figured, get up and go play. I couldn't get it off my mind. So it's like, oh, it was driving me crazy. I just figured, I need to just go have some fun. Just go do it. Couldn't shut my mind up about it, so figured I better get down here and just play. I made the some embeds last night. They're glycerin embeds. And see how it kind of speckles? I'm hoping a lot of that will go away when I stick blend, but we'll see, I guess, huh? But anyway, so I came down and popped them out this morning. They were so cute. So that'd be fun to use them. I wasn't planning on making soap today, but couldn't shut my mind up when I went to or when I climbed back in bed this morning. So here I am. So what we'll do is I'm going to go ahead and do a little stick blending here and see if I can. See what we can get it looking like. This is pretty much good. I don't think I have to do too much. That's pretty well mixed up, so. Start to burp it when it's already kind of thick. Get some of that white off the stick blender. That'll help a little bit. Oh yeah, see it lightened it up. That's cool. It's already getting a little thick on me, and I haven't even added the fragrance oil. Okay, I'm afraid to do too much more because I don't want it to get hard too fast on me. So, what I'm going to do is just hand blend in the fragrance oil. Oh, and it smells fabulous. A floral. I would say it has florals and fruits in it. I can't remember. I read it back when I ordered it. I didn't reread the fragrance description recently, so I just know it smells good. Okay. So So that, I'm going to have to make sure that gets... make sure that gets hardened up enough to do some piping. I'm just going to pipe enough on the top to you know, set the embeds down in it, so okay, my bird needs to shut up. It's really loud. Might have to go be a mom in a minute here. Okay, sorry. Can't handle that. Just a second. Okay, that may or may not work. Birds have a mind of their own. And you know, I can't really get mad. Whoa, that is like stuck in there. You know, they get excited when they hear your voice, so it's kind of one of those things. Boy, that got thick, didn't it? Clean that off as good as I can because I need to use it for the. Geez, I'm making a mess here. For the white. And I don't want that turning it pink. Isn't that funny how this one that I had put more color in got thicker? That's just a gloppy mess, isn't it? See if I can do this without splattering all over the place. Looks really light on camera, but it's actually a darker color. And of course, the colors for inside the batch got nice and thick, but the topping that I need to get thick isn't thick. Okay. That's pretty good. That's pretty good. So it looks like I'm going to be doing some glopping. Which is fine, because I'm going to try to stir it up a little bit anyway, so. This little spatula is not good for that, because it's so tiny. Much better. Boy, this would be good piping consistency. Too bad I'm not using it for piping. Oh, funny. But the embeds are, you know, the real colored ones, so I wanted to just do a white top for those. Sorry. Oops, I know that's really loud. But it's gotta be done, peeps. Okay. Some more pink on here. What I did, though, is last night I was just playing with the embed molds. Like I said, I wasn't planning on making soap today, so I only made 6 of the big ones. And, I actually can... I'm going to have to use some small ones to fill the mold up, really. But that's okay. Like I said, this was unplanned, so... It is what it is, and that is okay by me. This is a beautiful fragrance. It reminds me of like a light perfume. It's really super feminine. Which I just love me some of that. Okay, let's smack this down, if I can. And what I think I'll do is just take this, this skewer. Way for you to see this. Just kind of go through like this because it's pretty thick. I'm not thinking I'm going to get that much of a stir going on. Maybe, maybe no. I think, if anything, I'm just working air into it. Boy, that's warm soap. It'll warm up on me. These are kind of hard to smack down because they're silicone, so they give. You can't really get that true smacking, and I apologize because, like I said, I know that is insanely loud on camera. But when it's this thick, not much you can do. And look at this. Of course, what I need to pipe with is just nice and fluid. So, what I'll probably have to do is just pause the video and come back to do the piping. Because I'm going to have to clean this off. I don't want to put that in the white. So I gotta clean that off, and I'll get a little cleaned up and give that some time to thicken up. So I'll be back. Okay. I am gonna do some piping. No idea. I had nothing planned as far as how to do the piping. So, what I really like is when you can see the... let's see. When you can see the color, you know, on the sides. So I'll try to do something where that really stands out, but I have a lot of piping here in this bag. So, went off crooked here. I'm just going to kind of do whatever. And really, this middle part's going to get squished with the embeds anyway, so it's not that big of a deal what this looks like, because, it, like I said, it just gets squished anyway. And if I have leftover, I will just go ahead and maybe make some piped flowers or something like that. But I do really need the middle to be done pretty good, because... my embeds are huge. In fact, they would barely, I think, they're almost as wide, if not as wide, as the mold here. So, I'm going to just really build it up in the middle. That way I can squish them down in and it'll just look really cute being a tall top soap. It gives me lots of room to squish them down in there, so that's a good thing too. Some of them that I'm using though are small because like I said, I only made 6 of the big ones. So, I'm going to do actually, I'm going to go ahead and put some sprinkles on now. I think it just tends to be a little easier than when you, you know, are putting the embeds. You have those kind of in the way. So what I have are little pink, yellow, or pink, yellow, hello. That's what happens when you wake up early. Pink, white, and red. Sprinkles. Yes, these are probably going to interfere with my cutting, but that's okay. They're so cute. I'm not going to go totally crazy with these, but I just thought they'd be so cute. Just going to get them on the sides here a little bit. Because you know me, I just love me some foofy soap. It's kind of my thing. What, you know, get all reds in one area. What up with that? We need some pink going on. How about some white? Much better. You try to drop them randomly and they'll pile like there. Come on, pink. Yeah, that'll look cute. Anywho's, okay, and then I'm also going to do just a few little pink balls here and there. These are all sugar. There again, don't want to go too crazy because I do that way too easily. Okay. And last but not least, ooh, my lid was loose. Whew, it's a good thing I checked that. Yeah, we'll go ahead and sprinkle this on. It comes out really fast out of this, though I have to be careful. This is kind of that pink. It's got some green in it and or gold or something. Isn't that just cute? Okay. And now for the cutest part of this soap. Look at those lips. Mwah! Okay. So what I need to do is stay within, let's see, let me go. The second one. Why am I shaking? I never shake. I'm not a nervous Nelly kind of person, but for some reason, I'm shaking. So I have to try to keep these to where I can cut them easily. Okay. Kick my shoes off. I'm tripping on them. Okay. I have to make sure and push them all the way down because I don't want them falling out when I'm cutting. That would suck. Okay. Another pink and get it on your fingers, and you're going to get it on the lips. And last but not least, another red. Boy, that the loaf is already hard. I can't even push down into it very easily, so that's okay.
Aren't those just adorable?
I know, huh?
Okay, and what I did is I had some leftover little, little roses. I had some soap left over, so I made some little roses and little daisies, I guess. So what I want to do on this one is just put a daisy in there, because you know, the outside, I'm gonna make this one whole slice, so the back side will be the end of the soap, not the you know, not the front. It just doesn't look as appealing. Okay, and then I'm gonna put a little rose on the other end. And what I think I'll do, is take these cute little hearts, because I want to dress those little sides up a little better. See if I can manage to do this without fumbling it. Okay, I can't do it with the gloves on. So, I'm going to do a little heart there. Make sure I'm facing them the right way. A little heart there. Oh, that's cute. And I will do one here. And here. Okay, that's cute. Gosh, you know, I wonder if those would look cute with some glitter on them, but I don't know if I can get it to spread out well. Yeah, I think I'll leave them like that, because I always glitter over the embeds, but I think those are looking kind of cute just the way they are. I like how they're really shiny. What I used was these molds. Can you see that? Yeah. They're actually lollipop molds from, don't smack the soap, what up? From Joann's. They had these on sale right now, so they're like $1.99, then they're on sale from there. So I got those and thought they'd be so cute. So anyway, guys, hope you like. Thanks for joining me. And I will attach the cutting video on the end. Have a great day. Bye-bye. Or bye for now, I should say. Hey guys, it's Mel, BodyCareBoutique. And I am going to cut my GIMME KISS soap. And I'm not even sure how I'm going to do this, because I'm probably going to get some drag through the soap, I can imagine. But we're just going to have to make do. I might have to use my planer. And what I need to make sure I don't do is to cut the front of the lips, the lip embeds. One thing I did notice with this soap, I left it in this Crafter's Choice mold for 2 days instead of unmolding it in a day, and it went a lot better. So I'm thinking it just may be the better way to go. So this one, the little embed's so tiny, the front of it's all covered. That's okay. It still looks cute.
There's a movie playing in the living room, so you'll probably hear some rumbling and loud noises. That's what it is. To make sure and get this. I don't get too much drag through, because that can be a real bummer. Ain't that cute with your big old lips? Give me a kiss. So, I noticed this is a lot, the swirls turn out pretty. It's a lot harder than my Seahawk soap was with unmolding the Seahawk soap after a day. So, anyway. Yeah, it's cuteness. It's got the little sprinkles and glitter and all that. But I do like this consistency better for unmolding and cutting for sure. So that's cool. It's not quite so sticky. And I can't guarantee that these bars are going to be 1 inch, because I try to get them even, but it doesn't always happen the way we want. And we're working with embeds, so. Ish what it is. And I did read up, after I made this, on the fragrance oil. I got hole there, which doesn't surprise me because this got kind of thick on me. It's not supposed to discolor or anything, so hopefully that will be how it goes. Considering I didn't look it up right before I made it, because I bought this fragrance a while back. And I put the fragrance oil in the topping, which I normally don't do. I just wasn't paying attention because it was like really early in the morning when I made it. Cute. Oh, that looks pretty. I like those swirls. Cute. I just love these lips. They're just too adorable. That's just making a mess everywhere. There again, one thing I love about this Bud Hafner soap cutter is you can, I'll show you in a second, but you can leave the handle, it'll stand up, it doesn't fall when you, pretty. When you let go of it. And I love that, because when you're doing something like this where you're trying to center it correctly, it just makes it so much better. I'm getting lots of stuff down in there that I don't have. Let's see if I can. Get down in there and get some of the, there's a little candy sprinkle thing down in the groove. That's a little better. So what I'm trying to say is, I'll show you. See, when you do that, you can let go of the handle and it doesn't come down, and you can line up your soap where you want it. And I really love that feature. That's very nice, rather than one that just falls down, you know. He made it so it's nice and tight. I like that. Well worth the money. Pretty swirls. I can't decide what I like more, the pink lips or the red lips. I like them both. They're cute. I just couldn't help myself when I saw the mold. I was like, oh, I have got to use those. Especially with Valentine's Day coming. It's just kind of one of those things. It goes with holiday coming up. And I just love heart stuff and foovy stuff anyway, so I'd make this whether or not it was Valentine's Day coming up. Can't help the fact that I am a girly girl. Love feminine stuff. Pretty. I'm really happy with it. And it smells really nice. It's just so feminine. I don't know how else to put it. It's soft, it's light. It's not an in-your-face kind of fragrance. Floral. And see, there again, what I did is put the back of the embed on the two ends of the loaf toward the end so that the front side of the soap is the pretty side, the side that you can see the front of the embed. So, anyways, guys, there is my GIMME KISS soap. Hope you enjoyed. Thanks for watching, and I will see you in the next video. Bye.